VHS tapes. Those are my Star Trek TOS tapes. I'm not even a nerd.
Well, okay. Welcome back, everybody.
Hi there. This is Ava Marie Taylor.
And Omi Cass.
And Meechun.
Hi!
And we're playing Trauma Team.
Yes, we are. We're still in Naomi's part.
First,
yep.
You replace a glass of water at the table.
No, we're not in Persona. Although it's by the same people.
Oh, no wonder it looks so.
You could also put quicklime around the floor and on the table near the glass. When the table falls over, the hydration heat caused by the reaction would cause a fire.
So in the last video, we're just kind of piecing things together.
Why did a killer go through such a complicated plan?
We're pretty much towards at the end of this case. So
the reason the killer used such an elaborate trick to start a fire was to delay when the fire started. To prove how smart he was, variety.
That's just how we roll.
That's just how he rolls.
They see me rolling.
They see me trolling. They hate.
They see my mowing. My front lawn. Okay.
That's the delay when the fire started.
Yeah. Well.
That's right. If all he wanted was a fire, he could have just set something on fire. The killer needed to have a delay until the fire began. That's why he devised a plan that made use of two components.
The two things used to start the fire in the room were a bed and a glass, a ceiling fan and a rope, a table and the door, willpower and pyrokinesis.
Yes!
Pyro?
Pyro.
Yay.
Willpower and pyrokinesis all the way.
All the way across the sky.
Like an intense double rainbow.
Relied on a ceiling fan and a rope. The killer wrapped one end of the rope around the fan and tied the other to a table. When the fan activated according to its timer, the fan wound the rope up.
I'm gonna turn this up a little bit. I don't know.
Yeah, do it.
I don't know if like the video will be, you can hear it that well or not. Now he doesn't talk too loud.
Flipping the table over and spilling the water onto the quicklime. However, there's still one basic question left to be asked. Why did the killer have to set the room on fire in the first place?
Why?
Why go through this extravagant setup to make it happen?
The reason why the killer went to such lengths to cause a fire was to destroy the body, to burn down the building, so Dennis's body would be found. The killer wanted to be caught.
Exactly. Due to the fact that there was nothing flammable added to the body itself, the culprit never intended for the corpse and the evidence to be destroyed in the fire. Instead, the killer wanted to cause a commotion that would draw attention to the corpse. Now then, why would that be?
The reason why the killer wanted to intentionally have the corpse discovered was to create an alibi, destroy the ceiling fan, to taunt the police who felt pity for Dennis.
That's right. By delaying the start of the fire, the plan was to have enough time to create a viable alibi for when the fire began. It's easy. I mean, with this method of misdirection, the culprit could start a fire hours after having left the crime scene entirely.
Dun-dun-dun, solid evidence.
Solid evidence. Shiny!
This is the entire truth behind this mysterious arson.
We're almost done!
OMG, guys!
But I wonder why. I get the feeling that there's something very wrong about this.
The two accounts saw from different people who saw Dennis seemed to differ dramatically. The difference is nothing at all in Dennis' behavior. The recording quality, Dennis might not be dead.
Somebody!
Damn.
Shiny!
It's shiny. Dennis the pusher has been obtained.
At first glance, it doesn't seem like these refer to the same person at all. On the one hand, drug-dealing scum enjoying his life. On the other, a man with suicidal depression. Either one of these clues is false, or there's more to this shady business that I haven't found out. In either case, the truth of the matter is that he was indeed a drug dealer.
dust thing.
Huh? No, you don't use that like at all. Until a lot later. I'm stupid. There's something that doesn't quite fit here considering the victim's coming to death. I should go check the personal effects once more.
Personal effects time!
I found the true cause of death. Now there's something that I have to go back to.
There's something missing that should be here. If the puncture wound in the abdomen is the true cause of death.
Judging from the damage to the corpse, the one thing that must be on the clothing at the same location. The screwdriver, drugs, bloodstains from the stab wound, a Jack Frost patch.
Referencing for the win!
That, this mascot, Jack Frost. Aww, that's cute.
There should be blood stains in a hole where the screwdriver went through his clothing.
Yep. Interesting clothing part is gonna change.
Yes. These pieces of information can tell us something. According to Mr. Taylor's friend, on the day of the incident, Dennis had been wearing...
What had he been wearing?
According to Dennis' friend's testimony, Dennis had been wearing a red t-shirt, white t-shirt, red sweatshirt, white t-shirt. Okay.
That's right. He was supposedly wearing a red Portland Jacks t-shirt that day.
He should have been wearing a Jackrabbit t-shirt.
But when his body was discovered, he was wearing...
When Dennis's body was found, he was wearing white shirt, red t-shirt, red sweatshirt, white t-shirt, white shirt.
Yay!
Yes.
Good job, kid.
His corpse was found wearing a white shirt. In other words, his clothing had changed. And yet, if that was all we know, we couldn't rule out if the deceased had changed his shirt himself. However, if he had, there would still be a discrepancy.
The white shirt the corpse wore doesn't fit the facts because no indication of the stab wound, no burns from the fire, no drugs on it, he wasn't wearing a shirt. No indication of the stab wound.
You're wearing a shirt, man. He's a guy, he can go without.
The corpse had a wound that wasn't reflected by the state of the clothing he was wearing. There's only one answer to this puzzle, and that is...
There's only one answer to this puzzle, and that is...
The external trauma on the body doesn't match that on the clothing. This means that... The killer made Dennis change.
The killer stole his clothes. The killer changed Dennis. Dennis was naked when he died. He was naked trying to perform an art example, or whatever that one was.
Oh yeah, I remember this.
Whoever had killed Mr. Taylor replaced the shirt he was wearing after killing him. The reason for doing that was...
The reason the killer changed Dennis' clothing after the murder was to steal his lucky shirt, to make it look like suicide, to leave a beautiful corpse,
some kind of ritual. Oh my gosh, me shut up! I hit my computer!
Ow!
It was probably to hide the stab wound and make us believe that the killer's...
Wow, guys.
Pardon us.
These two are related. There are no vital reactions to the broken finger. That means the damage occurred after death, considering that the killer must have changed the victim's clothing after death.
The victim's finger was broken after death and his clothing was changed. This shows that the killer really hated Dennis. The killer liked Dennis' fashion and was broken while changing. The killer had OCD. Oh, that was enjoyable.
I bet. Solid evidence.
Solid evidence. Shiny evidence. Appearance of suicide has been obtained.
That's right. The killer broke the corpse's finger while changing the shirt on the body.
Raymond.
Dr. Kimishima, how's the investigation going?
I've almost uncovered the deception, but the truth hasn't completely been revealed.
I see.
Lame.
So we can't arrest the culprit yet?
That's right. I need conclusive evidence that can help us identify the killer.
Yeah, I need to switch where I'm sitting now.
The most reliable giveaway would be if we could find a finger. However, only the victim's fingerprints were found when HQ searched the room.
I'm not surprised, considering the length the killer's gone to hide his tracks. The murderer was probably wearing gloves while the crime was being committed.
Isn't there anything the killer might have touched?
Something that would require him to take his gloves off? It's hard to think of anything.
Well, the best evidence would be on a hard, slick, inorganic substance. It doesn't matter what size it is.
All we can investigate is the crime scene, the corpse, and the corpse is wearing.
AMT!
Could there be anything among those items that the killer will have to investigate?
Oh, it's doing really good! AMT! No, what? Don't judge me. We're gonna find something hard and smooth to use.
That would mean that the killer would have had to button the shirt up.
Oh no, I'm scared of a new car.
Buttoning up a shirt with gloves on is no easy task. If my predictions are correct.
Ooh, do the thingy. Can you do the thing?
What thingy?
Oh, like, move it all thingy.
Now I'm the personal effect.
Oh. Darn sweet.
The buttons on the victim's clothes, huh? I'll look into them right away.
Hopefully this will help us find the identity of our mystery murderer.
Okay, we are actually at like, 12 minutes. Alright, so we're gonna stop here.
Alright, guys.
Next video, we will finish Naomi's part.
OMG!
And depending on how quick we finish, we may start someone else's part.
Yep. So, see you guys later. Peace and long life.
Okay, bye.